I was recently giving a presentation, and one of the questions from an attendee was, what happens if you fund a 529 plan, and then your child or grandchild ends up not going to college? Well, it was a wonderful question and something that I talk through regularly with families, and you do have a couple options. In today's world, traditional four-year college isn't going to be for everyone. There's different careers, different life paths that college education may not matter or may not be needed. And so with every investment, every retirement plan, it's always making some sort of prediction of the future. And it's no different with college savings, like a 529. You are saving for today in, you know, predicting to take care of this large expense and, you know, help your child, grandchild, or another family member down the road. So luckily, there are a few different options. I'd say one common misconception about 529 plans in particular is that they must be used at traditional four-year universities. Luckily, that's not the case. That money can be used towards a two-year college program. It can be used towards vocational schools, other trade schools, so there are some options there. If college just isn't in the picture at all, the money can be transferred to a new beneficiary. Let's say these were funds that were growing for your daughter to go to college and she decides it's not for her. Well, that 529 can be transferred to a cousin, it can be transferred to another child, grandchild, your grandparents, it could be used by you. Maybe you decide to go back to school and get a master's degree or finish up that degree that you never did back in the day. There's a lot of flexibility in moving that 529 to another beneficiary. And finally, if it comes down to it, you can withdraw that money for non-college expenses. It will just lose its benefit. So the real incentive behind a 529 is it's very tax advantaged because it's specifically set aside and meant to promote saving for college. So if you end up using that money for other reasons, all of the earnings or the growth in that account, it's going to be taxed as income plus a 10% penalty. So there is always that way out, but you'll consider all of your other options beforehand. And today was really focused on 529s, but there are a whole host of other ways to save for children, grandchildren, and future gifting. So if you have any questions around saving for college or just saving for kids, grandkids, family members in general, please feel free to reach out. I'm always here and happy to help. Take care.